Imagine you got thousands of photos and videos on your Google Photos and you want to download them all in one go. Unfortunately, Google Photos doesn't allow to download more than 500 at a time. However, there is another way that Google provides that you could download all your photos and videos from your Google Photos. So, let's get started. First, go to Google and just type Google Take Out. Select that, and then you should see the link takeout.google. Select that. As the description says here, Google allows you to copy the content of your Google account, such as Google Photos, outside Google so that you could upload it somewhere else or store it on your computer. By default, all the services are already checked. But because we want just Google Photos to be downloaded, then select this deselect all to uncheck all the other services, then scroll down until you find Google Photos, then select Google Photos, and then it shows you multiple formats of the things that it would download. For example, photos would be downloaded in their original format, such as PNG, JPG, and videos also would be downloaded in their original format. So if you're happy, just click there, okay. Also here, you could select the albums. So if I click on here, I could select which albums to be downloaded, photos from 2021 or photos from 2020. You can uncheck if you don't want a certain period, then click on OK. So we selected just to export our Google Photos, then scroll all the way down, and we need to now click on next step. So in here, Google allows you to choose the delivery method. For example, by default, the link would be sent to your email. But if you click on here, you could transfer all your photos and videos to these other places, such as to Drive, to Dropbox, to OneDrive, or to Box. But I leave it as default so that I will get the download link to my email. Do you want this link to be emailed to you only once? So select this, or you want the link to be sent to you every period. So if I select this, then every 2 months for 1 year, it would keep sending me the link to download, but I'll go with only once. Here you can choose the different file type and size. So file type can be zip or TGZ. I will stay with zip because you can open zip on any computer. You can also set a limitation to the zip files. By default, it is set to 2 GB, but you can increase it, for example, to 4 GB, or you can increase it to 10 GB. And as soon as you do that, it gives you a warning. Exports larger than this size will be split into multiple files. Zip files larger than 2 GB will be compressed in ZIP64. Older operating systems may not be able to open this file format. There are external applications that can be used to uncompress ZIP64 files. So basically it says if you go anything more than 2 GB, then it would compress it into ZIP64 format, which you might not be able to open in any computer. You might need a third party software to do so. But if you select 2 GB, and if your data is more than 2 GB, it would organize it into multiple 2 GB zip files so that you could open them in any computer. So for convenience, I will go with 2 GB for now, but you could try with 10 GB or more. And then we simply click on Create Export. And here it gives you a export progress. And it says Google is creating a copy of files from Google Photos. This process can take a long time, possibly hours or days to complete. And once it's completed, you will receive an email and then you could download. So all we need to do is now just to wait for the email with the link to download all these photos and videos. Or you could also create another export. But for now, I leave it there and we wait for the email. For me, it didn't take much time. I stayed on this same page and it already created. So it says, before you copy your data to another service, check that temporary data export policies. And it says, make sure you can take your important stuff like your photos or contacts with you if you ever want to leave that service. Avoid downloading your exports onto public computer or saving them where others can see them. Okay, if you click on here, it shows you that you are downloading Google Photos. And if I click on here, it would ask you to log in again and then you could download. As you can see, the download is started and all you need to do is just to wait for the download to complete. You could also go to your email. So if I now go to my Gmail, for example, you should get an email from Google Takeout. If I open that email, and within that email, there will be a download link. So you can select on this button on here to start the download from your email as well. And also remember, it is a copy of your Google data. It doesn't delete your Google Photos. It makes a copy of your Google Photos so that you could download them. Now on your computer, if you go to the download folder, you see a zip file downloaded. If you double click on it, you could open it directly, and then there's another folder called Takeout. Double click on it again, it shows you archive browser as well as another folder called Google Photos. Double click on it, there you have another two folders. One is photos from 2020 and the other photos from 2021. So if I click on 2020 and I will select just anyone, you can see the photos are downloaded. If I go to 2021 and select anyone here, you can see the photos are downloaded.
I hope this video was useful. If it was, please don't forget to watch my other videos on my left and to subscribe to support my channel. I hope to see you in my next video. Bye bye.